Assalamualaikum and a very good morning. My name is Nur Mardiah binti Muhammad Azizi with matrix number B091810240 and from class BMMM11. So for today, I would like to present about the building services in F3. So for today's presentation, I would like to share about the introduction of F3 building history, service facilities concern, problems, and type of maintenance, costing, discussion and recommendation. Factory 3, or known as F3, of Faculty Teknologi Kejuruteraan FTK, was located at Taman Tasik Utama, Ayer Keroh, Melaka. F3 is a building that has lecturer's room, lecture rooms and laboratories, which is suitable for Faculty of Mechanical and Manufacturing Engineering Technology FTKMP department. Before the establishment of FTKMP on 1st July 2018, F3 building was part of a local factory, which before University Technical Malaysia Melaka, UTM, take over. As I mentioned, the history of F3 building is a local factory, which may lead to some improper design or poor building services before UTEM take over. So on today's presentation, I will highlight some of improper design and poor building services by making sure F3 is standardized with educational facilities for all. Furthermore, I will list out maintenance type and proper action that need to be taken in F3 building. Since the establishment, there are some problems occur in F3 building itself. As I observed, there are three major problems happen in F3, which are toilets, lecture room and lab facilities, and building design. In the toilets, the issue are broken hand wash dispenser, clogged toilets and broken faucet. Meanwhile, in lecture rooms and lab, they have flip chair broken or seat detached and projector sometimes malfunction. Lastly, the building design of F3. From my observation, I found that F3 has low ceilings, poor design of lecture rooms and poor ventilation. So for the next slide, I will show you the evidence and why it happens. As you can see for the next slide, these are the evidence picture that happen in the toilets and lecture rooms and lab facilities. For the F3 building, I point out some of issues that happen in the building itself. So in the toilet, we have broken hand wash dispenser, clogged toilets and some broken or missing faucet, and they also have water leakage since the faucet is broken. So for the next slide is in lecture room and lab facilities. The flip chair provided in the room have missing armrest, or the seat is detached, and also the projector sometimes is malfunction, which there is no signal or distorted color image happen. Now for the F3 building design itself, it have three major concerns from my observation. Firstly is low ceiling, which it does not follow the NPFA 72 codes, or known as fire alarm and signaling codes, and it involves safety issue. Secondly is the poor design of lecture room, which it's quite compact, cramped and beside each other, and it also have incorrect material selection and physical property. And lastly is the poor ventilation. I found out that the lecture room does not have window, which the windows serve as a respiratory organs and passage for building. Next slide is type of maintenance. There are four types of maintenance that can be done in F3 building services. Firstly is corrective, which I suggested it for toilets. Due to vandalism, I think maintenance team can take action since all of the problem occur and categorize as breakdown, as this is unplanned maintenance type. Secondly is preventive. The broken flip chair, water leakage in faucet and malfunction in projector are suitable with this type of maintenance. By repairing them, they could take preventive actions as they are aware vandalism might happen again. For projector, I think it is best if maintenance team and IT team up together and monitor the projector monthly to see any issue. Moreover, I also mentioned in the report that the completely broken flip chair can be sent to the recycle center and make profit from it. Thirdly, condition based maintenance, or known as CBM. For for water shortage, maintenance team can predict this incident happen a lot during dry season. So I suggest to maintenance team to make reminder to all students and UTEM staff. Lastly is failure mode and effect analysis, or known as FMEA, which the redesign and reviewing F3 building. I suggested maintenance team to take serious by implementing risk assessment and FMEA. As I mentioned above, the F3 building design itself have some issues like low ceiling and poor ventilation. So I will elaborate more about this in the discussion. Now for the costing part. This is just rough costing for replacement of equipment if there's any broken happen. So let us assume if all of the equipment are broken. For the hand dispenser, it costs RM550 for 30 pieces. Next is faucet, which costs RM960 for 30 pieces. Now for flip chair, it will cost around RM24,600 for 300 pieces. But maintenance team can cut the cost for flip chair if they recycle and send it to recycle center. For the projector, it will cost around $35,000 for 20 pieces of projector. That includes from lecture rooms and laboratories. Lastly, the cost for F3 renovation, if there are any renovation happen, it will cost around $380,000. Or less. This part is quite crucial because this is a big project, and I suggest maintenance team to review the F3 building plan first. Now for the discussion part, I mentioned there are three major things that happen with the F3 design, which are poor design of the lecture room and laboratories, low ceilings, and poor ventilation. First is the poor design of the lecture room and the laboratories. Okay. The reason is because the design of the lecture class and laboratories are quite compact, cramped, and beside each other, which contribute to thermal expansion and movement if the ceiling, walls, and doors will collapse when fire break out. Okay, this is due to the material selected for ceilings, walls, and doors that have very fine levels of absorption of each material, which will impact the surface and cause different pattern of water concentration to run off and stay on the facade. The use of such concept clearly suggests that incorrect material selection and lack of understanding of their physical properties would have an effect on potential building maintenance. Secondly is low ceilings. As I observed, I found that the height of the ceiling did not follow the NPFA 72 code, which the ceiling should be 4 meter and above. This is because when fire break out, there will be poisonous smoke appear. The reason to crawl is to reduce the hardness of breathing while escaping from the fire, or probably from the smoke. As soon as fire broke out in the building, smoke will start to cover the entire building except few inches over the floor just because of the warm surrounding air. Referring to poor design of the building, including lecture rooms and laboratories, a massive outbreak will happen in the worst case scenario, even though there are lots of evacuate doors. We should consider the amount of people in the building, laboratory, and laboratories equipment also. Thirdly is poor ventilation. Poor design and low ceilings also contribute to poor ventilation. I found that there is no window at the lecture rooms. This building contains a center type of air conditioner, which is suitable for a big building, but without windows in the lecture rooms, it's still considered not good. As example, students and lecturers were once reported that when the center air conditioner is out of service, they feel hot and suffocate in the enclosed building. This is because ventilation components in buildings such as windows, exhaust, and ventilation ducts and air passage serve as the respiratory organs and passages for buildings. Lastly is faculty building facilities. In F3, water shortage frequently occur during the dry season, and it also affects lots of other residential area, especially around the Taman Tasik Utama. But sometimes water shortage can occur because the amount of water cannot accommodate the whole FTK area, thus they might have water on another building but not in F3 as example. Vandalism also occurs in the toilet and the lecture room, which leads to broken, missing faucet and detached flip chair or missing armrest. I assume that this case is just a minor, but still need a proper maintenance for better facilities. Maintenance team can analyze the problem first before taking any actions, like making a weekly schedule to repair them or categorize them as preventive maintenance. Lastly, recommendation. I would like to suggest or make a proposal to FTKMP maintenance team to take a look and reviewing the design of F3 building by following the institutional standard building. In the discussion session, there are many issues that I highlighted regarding the design and the safety issue for students and staff, and it's a big concern. Poor ventilation, poor design of the building might lead to more disastrous event. It would be great if maintenance team undergo FMEA training. The FMEA training is an essential component of a preventive action program. This course helps you implement this vital methodology while analyzing risk, determining areas in need of action, and applying mistake-proofing techniques. From this training, they could enhance more of their skill as technician and have more knowledge about the FMEA. Moreover, I suggested actions that need to be taken care, including campaign awareness on vandalism. Sometimes students and lecturers complain because of poor facilities, including lack of maintenance, which it should not be happening in the FTKMP department. The comfort of students and FTKMP staff is UTEM responsibility, which it is reflection of a successful institutional. To conclude, if there's a complaint, a maintenance team should take action quickly by reviewing the maintenance type first. If it is compulsory or urgent types of maintenance, they should quickly fix and have proper maintenance. If it is not, maintenance team can plan their maintenance types that need to be done, such as preventive maintenance or condition-based maintenance for the whole month or annually. Moreover, if they can make profit, as I mentioned before about the recycle center, that will make a great cash flow. By analyzing the maintenance type and costing budget, maintenance team can make their work more easier and ease without using too much annual budget. So that is all for me. Thank you.